Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to multiply fractions with whole numbers. Let's take a look at our first example, and we're going to take 3/8 and multiply that by 7. Well, it's understood that if you have a whole number, its denominator is 1, so I'll put that in place. And when you're multiplying fractions, you're going to multiply straight across your numerators and then straight across your denominators. So here we have 3 times 7 to give us 21. And in our denominator, we have 8 times 1 to give us 8. And here we have an improper fraction. Let's not leave this as improper. Let's make this into a mixed number. So our denominator becomes our divisor, and our dividend becomes the numerator. So we want to figure out what times 8 will get us as close to 21 without going over. Well, 8 times 2 is 16, and then 8 times 3 is 24. Well, 3 is too much, so let's go back to 8 times 2. So 8 times 2 to give us 16, and then we subtract. Well, 21 minus 16 leaves us with 5. So here we're going to take the quotient of 2 to be our whole number part of the mixed number. And then our remainder, 5, is our numerator. And then the 8 here is our denominator. So when we multiply, we come up with 21/8, which is the same thing as 2 5/8. Let's move on to another example. This time let's multiply 4/9 times 6/1. So here we're going to multiply straight across the numerator, straight across the denominators. 4 times 6 to give us 24. And then 9 times 1 to give us 9. Again, an improper fraction. So let's do our division, where the 9 is the divisor and the 24 is our dividend. Well, 9 times 3 is 27. Well, that's too much. So let's use 9 times 2 to get 18. And then if we count up from 18 to 24, we're going to count up and end up with 6 here. So we're going to take our quotient, which is a 2. We're going to take our remainder, 6, to be our numerator, and we keep our divisor, 9. So we have 2 6/9, but you know what? I can simplify that. I keep the 2. 6 and 9 have a common factor of 3, so I can divide by 3. So 6 divided by 3 is 2, and 9 divided by 3 is 3. So really our answer here is 2 2/3. All right, let's look at a simpler way to do this problem. So we know we had the 4/9. Matter of fact, let's change the color to try to separate it some. We know we started with 4/9, and we multiply that by 6/1. Well, what we're going to do here is we notice that the 6 and the 9 have a common factor of 3, so I can divide each one by 3. Well, 6 divided by 3 is 2, so that's my new numerator. And 9 divided by 3 is 3, so 3 is my new denominator. Now I multiply straight across, 4 times 2 to give me 8, and then 3 times 1 to give me 3. And again, it's improper, so I do my long division, where my denominator is the 3, or is my divisor, and the numerator is my dividend. So now I'm asking myself the same question. What times 3 gets me close to 8 without going over? Well, that's going to be 2. 2 times 3 is 6, and then 8 minus 6 is 2. So here I'm going to keep this 2 here as my whole number part, my remainder 2 as my numerator, and my divisor as my denominator. And notice that they both came out to be 2 2/3, but after cross-canceling, I'm working with a much easier division problem. Let's move on to another example. This time, let's multiply 5/6 times 9. Well, it's understood that 9 has a denominator of 1. And again, we're going to multiply straight across. 5 times 9 is 45. And then 6 times 1 is 6. Again, we have an improper fraction. The 6 becomes my divisor. The 45 becomes my dividend. I need to multiply something times 6 to get me close to 45 without going over. If I do 6 times 8, I get 48. But if I do 6 times 7, I come up with 42. Now I subtract. 45 minus 42 is 3. And I'm going to keep my whole number of 7. I'm going to take my remainder, make that my numerator, and make my divisor my denominator. I have 7 3/6. Well, I can simplify that. 3 goes into both 3 and 6, so 3 divided by 3 is 1, and 6 divided by 3 is 2. So this here turns out to be 7 and 1 half. And let's do this same problem, but again we can do some cross-canceling. So we have 5 sixths times 9 over 1. Well, I can divide the 6 and the 9 by 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2, and 9 divided by 3 is 3. So now when I multiply straight across, I have 5 times 3 to give me 15, and then I have 2 times 1 to give me 2. Again, it's improper, so let's do the division here. My denominator is my divisor. My numerator becomes my dividend. What number times 2 gets me close to 15 without going over? If I did 8, will that be too much? Could that be 16? So I'm going to use 7. 7 times 2 gives me 14, and 15 minus 14 leaves me with a remainder of 1. I take my quotient of 7, my remainder of 1 becomes my numerator, and my divisor is my denominator. So we see that here comes out to 7.5, which is what we have here. And again, notice how my division has become simpler. That sums up this video by ajspeller.com. And as always, thank you for watching.